just before the oldest member of probability was born, a catastrophe wreaked havoc in the lands both near and far. The veracity of this terrible event exposed the long-standing fragile systems holding communities together in these lands. Whereas some communities advanced with an unprecedented level of cooperation, others elected to close themselves off from the rest of the outside, never again to be open. Such was the case of Pahel, where a fence was built around the small city. Decades later, when the catastrophe had long since passed, there were those in Pahel who, having gained power against the crisis, refused to relinquish. They achieved and maintained this by the destruction of all historical records and by the use of theory, rumor, anywhere, and stereotypes. However, as long as curiosity, intuition, and the interconnected web of life resonates in the human spirit, there will always be those who must heed their call. And none can this be found more clearly than in the case of the most curious and intuitive of them all, Miranette.
Before they could make it flew over the fence.
Before they could make it.
5 o'clock last night, perhaps a bit before,
or a tad bit after,
I was having my evening cup of tea, warm milk for me,
but none for me.
Heartburn! When suddenly something stirred outside, we were so scared we wanted to hide.
First a thump,
then a bump, then a crash.
A creature we believed
knocked over the trash. But before he got away, I saw his head all fall. I saw his body grotesque.
I saw his tail rotting.
Thank you. labels update. Check your sashes. Have any of you received any demotions since the last meeting?
Not me!
No demotions received. Next. Have any of you had a demotion removed for any good behavior?
No.
Me!
Good, Ned! The rest of you puff,
Ned!
It's really not that hard. All you have to do is smile all the time and never complain. Except when it's to point out other people's bad behavior. Look, I've nearly worked up all my demotions. At this rate, I should graduate by the end of the year.
But I still don't get how you sneak out beyond the fence and never get caught.
It's because I'm careful and smart when I sneak out. That's how. Not like the rest of you. In fact, look what I found yesterday. Show them, man.
What is it?
I don't know, but it's so mysterious. The best part is, when you blow into it, it makes a crazy sound.
Any trouble. It began when we were on the other side of the fence and we found some things crawling on a branch. They became covered in a kind of fuzzy stuff and we put some in a jar to show all of you.
Whoa.
But we were in such a hurry to get home that we dropped one of the jars.
Careless!
When we went back, we saw these things in the sky. One must have flown over the fence.
Wow! What about the noisy creature?
He doesn't look anything like their drawings. I found him beyond the fence. He had hurt arms, so I brought him back here. Last night, he got away from me. By accident. But I'm keeping track of him with this bell. Hey, Jingle, come out!
I wonder what they look like.
Choices of A, B, or C.
She often answers with deep. Give it false or true, she will circle them both, as if point or counterpoint will do.
No efficiency, no proficiency, this girl contributes nothing to our industry.
Maybe it's not important to you, but I'm tired of being the oldest person in Proper Girl, so having to wear this stupid sash. It's humiliating, and why would you even care what I think, how I feel? You're the one who stopped speaking to me. Out there calling me, but
won't be ridiculed for saying what I see, for saying what I feel. I won't speak anymore. Not until I'm heard. Really heard. And I'll never let them tell me again. Never.
Being unwanted is the worst. You try to fit in.
Thank you.
to show me something else? Wow. You found this?
Out there, by the stream. It's so shiny. No, I don't know what the medallion means.
Stop that, Miranette. You know, you can't wear that around here. Put this back on. Where are you going?
Paloma, you need to go home now. Your mom's furious.
Just a minute.
She says now, or you'll get a demotion.
Okay. You're determined to leave? With or without me?
Paloma, you're in big trouble.
I can't go with you. I can't get in trouble like I did before. I have to go. I'm sorry.
Mr. Stackhouse, see what's going on.
Are you really going to exit Proper Borough?
You really want to go all that way?
Aren't you afraid?
Isn't Paloma going with you?
Of course she's not. Paloma learned her lesson.
What if you wander off and meet some of the banished people?
Or meet the people who exited.
That's just a rumor. No one has ever really chosen to exit Proper Borough.
Did too.
Did not.
Well, I think you're very brave.
Me too.
Take this. The things in this jar will fly one day. I even put a light inside so you can watch them. Just to unscrew the lid when they're ready to come out.
And take Jingle. He'll keep you company. His arm's almost better, and he needs to go back to history.
And here's a place to plant in a special place.
Here.
I have no idea what it is, but it makes a crazy sound. Just don't try it until you're far away from here. I don't want to risk a demotion for bringing it in.
Children don't stare. They've just never met anyone from downstream before.
Come, join us.
Don't be shy. In the world of imagination, there's room for everyone.
In the world of imagination exists a world without limits. But to travel there,
right.
nectar for pollinating things, for flying things, for crawling things, for even slippery, slimy things.
Squish, squish.
Dragonflies, dragonfish, starfish, starfruit, dragonfruit, firelight and starlight.
You keep the clouds in your pants, and at any time you want, you throw them out to me.
Shape them any way that you like, release them high into the sky.
For every single person, and boy,
here, here.
Can there be sharks and bats with spiders and vultures?
And wolves and baby kangaroos.
I fly with birds, eagles, seagulls, and starlings, pelicans, geese and ducks.
Quack, quack,
quack, quack. And every firefly is dragonflies, dragonfish, starfish, starfruit, dragonfruit, firelight, and starlight.
We'll be sure to take this world of imagination with us, wherever we go. Oh, but right now, we were wondering if you might know where this shiny object might have come from.
Not quite sure.
It's really important.
There are many artists living at the very edge of these lands who make zuza-zuza things.
There's someone who might know.
Anahita and Tane, take them to see Rosetta.
Yeah!
Some starfruit lollipops for your trip?
Yeah.
Be sure to be back before dark.
Thank you. Zuza, zuza much. With it, you can hear sounds like you've never imagined. Try it.
What do you hear?
I hear
fish swimming deep in the sea.
Sorry, that was my stomach.
I hear a snail eating grass.
I hear.
I think I'll try this direction. Snow falling on the mountain.
And what about you?
What is it?
Incredible.
What do you hear?
I believe your friend has discovered
the sounds of the universe.
or fragments off into a super.
Some instruments for you.
To a bygone era where brave knights roamed the vast lands performing chivalrous deeds. The knights wore impenetrable armor like this to protect themselves from the swords and arrows of their adversaries.
Oh, that is quite dangerous.
Oh, I am a knight, and you are a beast, and I will hereby slay you in half.
No, I am a knight, and you are a beast, and I will hereby slay you in half.
You can't be a knight, you're a girl.
You can't be a knight, you're too young.
Forget that.
I'll send one of the video to the world.
Not before I cut out your insides.
Oh, come on,
Richard.
They're sharp.
Don't get hurt.
Oh, goodness.
Oh.
otherwise.
Yes, to think we once believed we could solve things in this way. In our younger days, we imitated the knights. For many years, we wore their armor. Until one day, we came to uncover something that would make us all the stronger. This vulnerability has made me parched.
Oh, fruit! The most delicious fruit in the land. But
Only someone with nimble hands can get it.
It seems like Jamie wants to get them for us. Is that right? Let me take off your bandage first.
Come on.
Hooray! Freckle fruit every day of the year!
Yeah.
good sirs, these dames are on an urgent quest of their own. You wouldn't happen to have any transportation they could borrow, would you?
I believe we do have a scooter.
From our younger days.
Perhaps even two.
Oh! Wow!
Now,
put one foot here and push with the other.
You're doing great. Fine job.
Oh my gosh, that's so great.
Keep going. Don't stop.
Keep pushing.
Come on.
Now follow this path very carefully. And remember,
maybe the other
don't
foot.
Get separated and certainly don't
wonderful.
Get lost.
Keep going.
Stop. Push.
And remember, when you finally find those artists, tell them to restrict their activities to daytime hours. Oh, goodness, I believe my ear detects a very strange creature with 12 legs. Oh, no, wait, 11 legs. Now it's 2 legs lurking about. All the more reason to get these children home. Come along.
was dragging behind you? Not funny. Oh, Balbo, Balbo, seems you lost your tail. Not funny. Oh, Balbo, can't join the 113th annual Draglian parade without your behind. Automatic disqualification. Mercy.
Yikes.
Goodness gracious me.
What iridescent creatures. They make me want to laugh. Oops. It makes me want to laugh. Let me tell you, it all started the day I realized I had a unique purpose for being on this earth. Thank you.
someone intelligent in a rather odd sort of way named Lego that might possibly help me.
Chumpy, do I really have to dust these books again? Well, it's only been 10 years.
Choo!
All right, but you know how much I hate having things out of sorts.
Lego, Chumpy?
Personified. It's Balbo. Lock the door! Touch those books. My books are very... Better not touch those bottles. Chumpy is very meticulous about her scent concoctions. In fact, she's quite a famous olfactologist.
Huh? Latin.
Correct! From the word olfactology, the chemical study of smell. Did you know Chumpy's nose is 100,000 times more sensitive than ours? Her specialty is finding the perfect soil for gardening. We're hoping to capitalize on her talent so she can support my passion for books. Alas, I have no new ones to read. My books? Young lady, I told you not to touch those.
Sorry.
Well, well. Here I was thinking I'd read everything in my library, but it appears I overlooked this one. 623 observations from a young mind, and what's this? It doesn't appear to be a regular book at all, but a box made to look like a book, with observations written on the backs of anything and everything, even on the back of this old chart. And I have you to thank for finding it. Well, I just can't resist reading a bit. This last one seems most intriguing. It's about a fiery angel. A seraph came to me one night, and this she had to say. Child, while you slumber, the world will seize the day. She told me then of prodigies, of names lost long ago. Miranette's daydreams. Very interesting. I don't believe I have a copy.
Look!
Whoa, what is it?
Look, Lego!
Remarkable! The circle on this chart seems to be a drawing of the same medallion on your necklace. And what's this? It appears that later today, an extremely rare celestial phenomenon will occur. Jumpy! Oh dear, oh dear! Oh, she's far too fast for me to chase after. Please!
Oh, you're always boring.
couldn't catch up with it. And now I know why. You were meant to find it. To make the long journey here and bring it back to this place. And to show me your vision. Ah! The summer solstice is about to start.
Its light shines here only once a year. Time to get ready.
Look, there's some cool things in that old suitcase over there.
Yes, put on whatever you want.
Thank you. Mesmerizing!
Sing a double, big a boggle!
Miranette,